Hey, welcome to the Champagne Wives podcast. I'm your host, Kelly.
And I'm your host, co-host, Nicole.
Hey, Kel.
Hey, boo.
How are you?
We are back on the location in the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Montego Bay, Jamaica.
Jamaica.
And we are super, super, super excited to be back this week.
I know. And what a beautiful place to start and kick off the first episode of season two. And we'd be remiss if we didn't start off with our just celebratory.
Of course. We're on vacation. It's a whole vibe. We have the beach in front of us. I wish you guys
could see
the beach. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous.
It really is. Jamaica never disappoints.
Never. So this is my second time here.
Oh, yeah.
In Jamaica. Yeah. I went to Ocho Rios maybe a few years ago, actually, for my sister's birthday. And it was such a vibe. Yeah. Like, I love Jamaica. Yeah. I love the people. I love the food. Mm-hmm. I love the culture. I got them.
This was what, duty-free moment?
It was definitely duty-free moment from the airport, the way that flight has been traveling, child.
Okay.
We tried. Okay.
It's all good.
Here we are.
Here we are.
Okay.
Let's pour it up. Kind of, this might not be the thing, but do you want to rinse it out with your mimosa?
No.
All right. It is alcohol.
Okay. It's alcohol.
So we're pouring.
Okay.
So, Kels, what have you been doing during our little hiatus?
I feel like we've been together the entire 6 to 8 weeks that we've been out.
We took a break.
A creative break is what we like to call it. Mm-hmm. We took a break and I feel like the work never stops because we were always talking about like what we wanted season two to look like.
Exactly.
And how we would prepare for it and get ready and content plan.
Yeah.
So I don't feel like we actually took a break. We took a break from recording, obviously, but we were definitely working.
Were we?
Other than that, spend time with family. I don't know, like rested.
Yeah, but it's spring break with the kids.
Spring break. Oh my God, spring break.
That was fun. Cheers. I'm sorry.
Hello. Spring break with the kids. Hi. Spring break with the kids.
Yeah.
We took them to Kalahari. You can see that fun video on our Instagram page.
Yes.
That was really cool.
Did some content.
Yeah, that's awesome. And again, just really planned and prepared for it. So I'm super excited to be back. I feel nervous a little bit.
Like, I know. I feel like a little out of the saddle.
I feel a little bit nervous. But y'all, we are so official. Like, now we have video. Like, we were able to set up a whole production on the beach. Can you believe it? How far we came?
I know. From a bathroom.
From a bathroom.
To a cabana bitch.
Do you remember how long it took us to set up production in your bathroom?
No.
It took us like 3 hours.
It did.
To figure out how to get the microphone away.
It did. And I think we just ended up talking on the phone.
We did.
So.
We actually did. Just to see like our progression from our very first episode to the first episode of season two. I'm just so amazed at the progress that we made.
Cheers.
Cheers, babe.
Cheers to progress. Cheers to progress.
Absolutely.
So, season two, I think it's so appropriate because we're season two. We just got 200 followers.
Yay!
Two and two.
So, 100.
Yes, I know. Thank you so much.
Organically, though. Like, our followers are growing organically. Yes. We're not buying followers.
No.
We're not compromising ourselves or our values.
Our authenticity.
Exactly. Like, we are doing exactly what Kelly and Nicole would do, like we're staying true to ourselves. Mm-hmm. Our followers are acknowledging that and recognizing that, and I just appreciate the fact that it's all organic.
Yeah, same, because I think there's a lot of ways that you can buy popularity, mm-hmm. you can buy followership, and I think that
for
just
sure.
is not in line with anything that we
subscribe
to.
Because when we wasn't getting past 110, I was like, what's our option?
Child.
How
does this work? But we had faith. We had faith.
Kept the faith. Definitely
did.
And we truly believed in like what we were doing.
Right.
What I mean? Like this, I call it all the time my passion project. And I just love doing it so much.
I know.
And I think that also helps keeps us going
mm-hmm.
when things start to look bleak.
Right. Bleak was the word. Because 110 had me shook for a while.
Again,
even during our time off, like we spent time networking, like
definitely
that we ran into, we would say, hey, like, what do you guys do? We would say, we have a podcast. Like, are you guys on Insta? Yes. Like, I know I went out to the West Coast and
got about 8 followers just from that little weekend trip. And, you know, I think it's just slowly getting our names out there and also just getting comfortable.
Oh, yeah.
You know, because that part.
Because I'm not, honestly, I am not the best networker. You're really good at networking. Girl, I will go places like to network events and forget my business cards. And I'm like, why are you here? Like, why are we? Like, I'm the worst networker ever. And I feel like you're so good at that.
I feel like you're a much better networker. Like,
really?
Yeah, I feel like you are. Because you know a lot of people. I know a lot more people than I do.
I do know a lot of people.
I feel like I got the gift.
But you're with the strangers, yes. So that's the yin and yang, right? Relationship, right? So you're really great at just sparking up communications, talking to people, just randomly.
Child, the communication finds me. The people find me.
But here, you were just like, I don't want to talk to these people. These people. That's for sure the palm of my hand. She's like, they
always find me. They always want to have a conversation with me. And I'm just like, guys.
You just have like the approachable energy.
I gotta get my RBF a little stronger, I guess.
Yes, girl, because mine be popping. I don't know what to say to her. Like, I don't know if I should say hi.
Even go to this
one. Exactly. Let me talk to this one. She seems a little bit more friendly.
Oh my gosh.
It's all good. It's all good. And so, yeah, so we're here in beautiful Jamaica, sis. I know that you've spoken about it a few times in season one, but you are Jamaican, both your parents are from Jamaica. We want to kind of talk about that. I feel like that's appropriate.
I feel like it's an appropriate place for us.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, mom and dad are both Jamaican, and, well, they're naturalized U.S. citizens now, but we're born in Jamaica, raised in Jamaica, and actually my mom's from Manchester, which is southwest on the island, and my dad's from a parish called, and think about a parish as like a state equivalent. So he's from St. Mary, and he's more from what we call country, because he grew up kind of in the hills, and I won't say the jungle, but in the hills. But when we do come back, we spend more time now in Ochi, because he has a property in Ocho Rios. So,
Ochi.
Yeah, so that's always a fun time. And this is actually my first time back in a number of years, probably actually ever, staying at a resort. So right now we're in Mo Bay, Montego Bay, and we're staying at a secrets resort. And it's beautiful, it's lovely, but it's the first time that I've ever really stayed like on a resort in Jamaica.
Yeah.
And if it's cool, it feels weird. I get why my family, when they do travel down here, they do like 4 days with family and then they do 3 days at a resort, because it's so relaxing, it's so peaceful. But there is a part of me that's like, I'm here, but I want to, like, I want to connect.
Be with the locals, right, and like talk. Food and
The way that I am dying for some kalalu and some breadfruit right now, it is literally
your brand that you call it.
Oh, breadfruit. Right. Oh, and then cocoa bread.
Cocoa bread. Yes.
Cocoa bread. Obsessed.
It's still going.
It's still going.
Oh, we're here. Yes. Make sure that our audio is still.
We are not in the studio. We don't have Adam. I don't know if you hear
the waves in the background, but it's amazing. So just make sure that we're still connected.
Yes, we are still here, bro.
But yeah, so we're going to do that today. Actually go out and try to eat some local food. And talking about like staying on a resort. I've stayed on my resort a few times. Like, the first time I was in Ocho Rios in Jamaica, we stayed at, like, a villa, and we had, like, the private, you know, villa, private beach, private chef, and whole staff, and that was such an amazing, luxurious experience, and I like resorts, don't get me wrong, but they can be very resorty.
Very resorty.
Very resorty.
And you're just forced to talk.
The social. Oh, everybody. The first night we got here, they had the talent show. It just put me in a space of.
The talent show. We need to talk about this. We need to talk about this talent show. Because.
Oh, the talent show.
The talent show. There were people who actually. Okay, so let me set the scene here. So I guess on property, they do this talent show every couple of nights, I guess every Wednesday night, they do this talent show and they have guests come who are guests on the property come and showcase their talent.
And the staff.
And their staff, because there's, you know, entertainment team. And so they'll come in.
They're really talented kids, young people that work here. The one who sang Adele.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Amazing.
He was so good.
He was amazing.
So there's this one guest, I presume, whose talent was to auction was like an auctioneer, so he could speak really fast.
Yeah.
Right. And so I guess it would be super funny if he were auctioning off something.
Girl, a seashell. It could have been anything.
The problem was he was auctioning off someone.
And this is the someone.
A black female. And this
one of the staff.
The staff. She was the host of the show.
The show.
And he was auctioning off this black female.
Don't talk low.
It just keep that same energy.
I need to keep that same energy. The way it was so inappropriate and like the level of situational awareness, social awareness, that was just absent.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that he thought that that was a talent for him to be like going to the highest bidder and he's running off these numbers and got to a point where he actually said sold, like we were in Charleston, South Carolina.
Girl, it was triggering. That was triggering. It was cringy.
It was so cringy.
And then here's the kicker. So he was auctioning off this female to a male. It was clear that this girl was a part of the LGBTQ community.
Yeah, like,
and
that wasn't the team.
That just was not the team, right? So it was just cringeworthy all around and super insensitive, right? And it's just like, just because you feel like a thing should be a certain way,
mm-hmm.
like thinking that, you know, women are, you know, and men should go together, you know what I mean?
Without recognizing the
fact that this girl, you know what I mean?
It's, yeah.
And it was just, I don't know, it was very out of touch.
Yeah.
Very, privilege.
It was incredibly privileged. Reeked of privilege. And, you know, like, there were so many things that were wrong with it, right? It's the, I failed to recognize that I'm auctioning off a human being.
Yeah.
I failed to recognize that, like, you know, I want to take race out of it, but we don't, and we shouldn't, because, like, we know what that's rooted in.
Yeah.
It was, like, failing to recognize that she might not even be interested in men and that might not be her preference.
Yeah.
It was failure to recognize that, like, you're on a Caribbean island.
Yeah.
And, like, a black Caribbean island. And that
Jamaica,
like,
girl.
The black island. Yeah, and the first island to get its independence. So from the British. So
it's a lot.
You know. So it was a lot.
It was a lot to take in. It was a lot to be in the audience.
Oh.
It was a lot to just, I don't know.
The level of boo that I wanted. I was like, boo.
I think we did boo.
Yeah.
I think we did.
And people looked at me like I was crazy. I was like,
yeah. I think we did boo. I think that, you know, the conversations that were happening around us was,
I didn't like
it. Was awkward. You didn't like
conversations? I didn't like the conversations because I felt like people were trying to, like, give him a pass.
Like, oh.
Like the
Jersey.
Okay. I felt like they were trying to give him a pass. Like, oh, like, that's his talent. I'm like, that's not a talent.
Yeah.
That's not a talent. That's racially insensitive.
Yeah.
That's a failure to have situational and social awareness. Like, if it's a talent, then he could have
auctioned off the chair.
A thing. Yeah. Right. A chair.
Yeah.
I agree.
Something. Yeah.
But
something other than a person.
Nevertheless, we did not let that derail us or derail the trip at all. But, you know, it was definitely a low point.
I would definitely say a low point. I would far of, like, being at these resorts, child.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah. Why? I just feel like, you know, they're cool, but at the same time, like, it can be super annoying.
No, we came in cow's dens.
Reserved it this morning.
Oh, okay. No, sorry. They didn't tell us that. Want to press pause real quick?
Sorry, guys.
Oh.
Yeah. Do you know me?
Yep.
Okay. Sorry, guys. We had to take a break because what I was saying before we stopped is actually what bothers me about being on a resort. So at these resorts, obviously everything is free. So you have, like, all of these day beds, cabanas and all of these things set up, but it's on a first come, first serve basis.
Right.
So people actually come down, like, at the wee hours of the morning to put towels or any objects on these day beds or whatever to reserve them for when they want to come down, right? So we obviously grabbed a David.
Yeah.
That was just sitting here idle, only had two resort towels and then, right? And nothing on it.
Yeah, no personal bag.
No personal bags. No personal items, nothing.
So the people, I guess, who put the towels down just came and they're just standing to the side looking at us like with the fucking dick face. Oh. Like, what's going on? I'm like, you see all this stuff set up. You see,
we have a production.
We have a whole production here. Like, why are you here? So we had to just take a quick break so that we could, you know.
Yeah.
Move them around because yeah. Everyone doesn't fit in my face.
Because the way I was like,
the way.
Like, y'all can go. They're like, no, this is our spot.
Did we try to dismiss those people?
Which I sure did.
Like, I sure did. Like, you're like, I get it. Like, I get, like, you thought you came down here and you reserved this space. At the end of the day, this is my choice. It does not have your name. That's why I like paying for shit. You know what
that
I mean?
That part.
Because when I pay for it, it's mine.
That part.
You know what I mean? You take ownership on something that you didn't pay for that's not yours. Mm-hmm. Like, what are you going to do if we say, I'm not paying? What are you gonna do?
I'll go check you.
I'll go check.
I'm going to check you.
Body. Body. There's nothing you can do. And if you, this man, want to go ahead on and puff on his chest,
but yeah, but that's what we'll be for that. It wasn't going to happen. But also, machine killer me.
Girl, the way go off because the way that I was had been anticipating the season 2 opener and we were in like the trenches of the recording.
Yes.
Girl,
where we were 15 minutes in, but
15 minutes in, but here we are.
Nevertheless, like I said, we're not going to let it derail us. Yeah.
So this is one of the things, the pitfalls of like staying at a resort, right? Some of the things that I do like about staying here,
the convenience.
The convenience, obviously, like mm-hmm. It's just like one stop shop. Like here,
yeah,
there's like 10 restaurants on property. There's like gift shops. There's coffee shops. Yeah. There's water sports. Beach right there. Like right. You go in, you eat, and you just get up. We talked about it at dinner last night. Mm-hmm. How there's like no commitment.
Yeah.
When you go to eat, you just eat and then get up and go.
That's right.
Now, the food sometimes is not all that great, however, because it's like a pre-selected menu.
And it was terrible.
Oh, my God.
The dry-ass ravioli.
You know what? My favorite food is chicken parmesan. I never had a bad chicken parmesan until last night.
Well, we can't come to Jamaica and order a pound.
That's exactly what I said last night. I was like, you're asking Jamaicans. Italian.
It's just, if it's Rasta pasta, they're going to nail yeah, it. Like, they're going to kill it, but just...
That's what I should have gotten the Rasta pasta. Right. I just know that I like chicken parmesan
wherever I go, child. So
wherever you go.
Even at Jody on Sound.
Meager like, everywhere. Everywhere. Here, there, everywhere. Chicken parmesan is my shit.
So, and for me, you know what I'm on? You know what I've been on for a while. This poke tuna.
Oh,
I'm loving this poke tuna. I didn't realize how much I love poke tuna until, like, maybe fall of last year, and if it's on the menu, I have to get them.
Yeah.
I have to get them.
Yeah.
But you do, like, you will get that finger palm. Even if we're going somewhere, you got a fitted dress on, sis, you won't get that.
Yeah. I'm
thinking of putting more attention.
Because, first of all, the ladies, you know, my metabolism has slowed down.
It's calmed.
It's calmed.
As well.
It's calmed.
Mine as well.
I really have to be more conscientious about, like, what I eat, because it doesn't, a workout is not, my weight is not going the direction that I need it to go.
And it will, but I'm going to tell you, like, and I know we're our own worst critics, yeah. But I know what I'm looking at right now in the bright pink walking across listen, but I know when we come to these spots at the end of the day, body's giving. Body is giving.
And I'm proud of that.
That's it takes hard work. Like, it's commitment. You be in there 3 days a week, you know, to me, 4 days a week, like,
you're 4 or 5, so yeah, that's what it takes, but... Yeah, guys, we just wanted to tap in, you know, for season 2, on-site, on-location in Jamaica, get back to the studio. Is next week?
Next week, we said we were going to get back into the studio, and we have a lot, like, we have been episode planning, y'all.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
We have some really exciting content that we're thrilled to share with you.
So excited.
We got some great feedback from...
Great feedback.
From listeners, from dear friends, just about how... We should really call a thing, right? And that how we shouldn't beat around the bush. And so we're going to lean into that feedback.
Yeah.
And we're excited to really just continue to show our authentic self, set of selves,
yeah,
if you will. We have topics related to relationships, topics related to just
family.
Yeah. We're going to look at relationships past and present.
Yeah.
We're really going to peel back the layers of the onion just as it relates to
who we are, how we became who we are, and the people that in our lives that influence that. Not too much, though.
Well, I was about to say, because you know what? It's hard. Like,
it's a balance. It's a
balance,
for sure.
Yeah, it's definitely a balance, yeah. But definitely more transparency and openness in our communication. Like, if I want to say fuck shit, bitch, or dick, or whatever it is, like, I'm going to say it. Because first of all, I think I was trying to be a little bit too coy.
Are you saying
that when you're intimate with a person? Right.
No, see, I'm not doing all that.
Are you trying to call a thing a thing?
Right. Exactly. Yes.
A thing is going to be a thing if you do. I'm super excited about that. It's going to help me come out of my shell a little bit more. Sis. I know that
I'm already on the show.
Kind of sort of, because when we had that
keep it as sexy.
I didn't say that shell, sis.
I was all almost clammed up.
Clammed up like hard. I'm getting there. But I think season two is just going to be a lot more of us coming into ourselves, you know, coming into the podcast, becoming more of a podcaster, as opposed to, you know, two friends, really great friends and neighbors who just decided to go on this journey together.
Yeah.
So super exciting. We also have a YouTube channel coming.
Great.
So trying to definitely get more visuals out there to folks.
Because clearly y'all like the visuals. We see you. And we see you seeing us. Oh. That's
whoever the now.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Here we are.
Here we are. So yeah, I think our visuals, I mean, we spend a lot of time aside from that. We spend a lot of time trying to figure out like what looks good, what works, like how we want to present ourselves, what will connect with our audience.
Yeah.
So yeah, so I think that it's not just taking pictures. It's actually there's a lot of thought and preparation and planning and execution.
For sure. And for us, it's also about like just making sure that it's consistent with our message, right? And our message is really about continuing to uplift women, trying to inspire women, trying to make sure that women understand that, like, you are not relegated to wearing one hat. You can wear the multiple hats and you can do them all equally well and be successful in all of those spaces and be sexy. And you are not losing your sense of self because you lean into one role.
One or the other.
Exactly. So
what's upside down? Let me tell you something. I had to unpack in 8 weeks too.
That's true.
Maybe an episode because I had to unpack some shit too. Because I'm like, I'm not Superwoman. I mean, you know, I try to do a lot. I try to do all the things that I can, but there are things on my priority list that, you know, I had to recalibrate. Because it was getting to be a little bit too much for me. It was a little bit overbearing. And so I had to kind of reshift.
Right.
And I did that. Unapologetically. Like, I was just like, absolutely not. Can't do this. Can't do that. Willing to do this. Hack to do that. And so if that's okay, too. But I'm super excited about this next season. We also have a new segment coming.
Yeah. So excited to share this with y'all.
Excited to share our new segment. So it's not a new segment, but it's just a new setup of our old segment, What's Poppin'.
What's Poppin'? Because first of all, we know y'all love What's Poppin'.
Yes.
And we feel like we do What's Poppin' a solid justice. But then we did Stuck
we
for
tried.
Life.
We tried it.
We just Stuck for Life. Part one, part two, and the good sis,
good journey,
aka Ijoma, aka Kim.
So if you guys don't remember, Good Journey is our good friend Kim Ijoma. Good Journey came on our episode.
She actually had these cups made for us, by the way,
for her birthday trip.
For her birthday trip that we didn't get to go to
because I caught COVID. And she
did you catch COVID though?
No, my test was positive, so my COVID test was.
But she was no symptoms.
But Nicole just couldn't go by default because
we were around too much.
But anyway, so she was on our episodes last season, our last two episodes, and she's just amazing. She brings such a great like energy and spin to pop culture and news.
I'll be right back.
It's hilarious. Chat with you
go.
Okay, so she just brings like a really cool element to pop culture and the news and what's going on in like a non-messy way, right? Like it's very witty and it's hilarious. And so if people hear themselves, I feel like on what's popping and hear her talking about a certain situation, I don't think they'll be offended, because I just think she presents it in such like a hilarious, non like messy type of way.
Yeah.
So we're super excited to have her join us. And yeah, we'll see kind of what happens from our What's Popping segment this evening.
Yeah, should be a really good time.
Yeah, for sure. What is
that? This just washed up ashore, and I'm not going to sit here and say that I am like a, you know, feed the earth, but I just felt compelled to not
run and get that.
I just,
in the middle of our show,
needed to not be floating. It just.
Okay, look, I'm about to come out. Salmon is creeping up. Come on.
Okay, so
where are my tap shoes, Shaq?
We got to go. So listen, yes. Great to check in. Great to tap in. Episode 1, season 2. So thrilled to be back. Looking forward to showing up for y'all in different ways. Online, on video, via Spotify, via Apple Podcasts, and all the Anchor and all the other spots where you listen to
now us. YouTube.
Now YouTube.
For sure.
Oh, and I forgot to mention, I told Kelly this last night. So we now have listenership in Jamaica, which only feels appropriate. Only feels appropriate. So, yeah, let's just keep growing this shit, bitch.
Now we're in Jamaica. We're in UK.
Saudi Arabia.
Mexico.
Canada. Australia. Growing it. Okay. All right. Thank y'all. Good to see y'all.
Thank you. Don't forget to follow us at Champagne Wives Podcast on Instagram.
Champagne. Oh, we're also on Facebook. Forgot to mention that.
Oh, yeah. On Facebook now,
so
too.
For the non-Insta people, we're on Facebook at Champagne Wives Podcast. Yes. And we'll get you the information on, I guess, our YouTube.
We just started this channel. Next episode, we'll have more information about our YouTube channel.
We're navigating through that. But yes.
Love y'all. We're so happy to be back. Love you, sis. We're going back and enjoy this beautiful beach and the beautiful weather in Montego Bay. Until next time. Peace. Bye.